You have $2, 3 quarters, 2 dimes, and 3 nickels to spend at the arcade. The race car rally game costs 275 cents. How much money do you have, and is it enough to play the game?
Welcome back. In our last quest, we added coins up to 100 cents. This time, we're going even bigger with values greater than 100. And this quest includes dollars too. Dollars and cents in the same problem? How are they connected? And how do we work with values greater than 100 cents? Let's dive in and find out. Mia is here to help us review the coins we know. Let's say each coin's value. A penny is worth 1 cent. A nickel is worth 5 cents. A dime is worth 10 cents. And a quarter is worth 25 cents. Great work. We write all these values with the cent symbol, but what about dollars? Have you seen a dollar bill before? Let me check my wallet. Oh, here's one. A dollar bill is worth more than all these coins, but how much more exactly? Since we're working with both dollars and cents in our quest, we need to figure out how many cents make a dollar. Oh, a clue. Let's see if this can help us. It shows 4 quarters are equal to $1. We saw this before in our last quest. Do you remember the value of 4 quarters? Right, 100 cents. So this means $1 is also equal to 100 cents. This will help us switch between dollars and cents if we need to. Let's make sure we understand this. If we have $1 and 1 quarter, how many cents do we have? We know our dollar is equal to 100 cents and our quarter is 25 cents, so we can add 100 to 25. That gives us a total of 125 cents. So $1 and 25 cents is the same as 125 cents. Great work. Even though we can turn dollars into cents, we don't always have to. When people use dollars and coins to buy things, they keep the dollars and cents separate, adding them up part by part. Let's practice this idea with a few story problems involving dollars and coins. Grab your pencil and work with me in your guided notes. Mia has $1, 1 quarter, and 1 dime. How much money does she have in total? Let's add pictures to help us solve. We can use rectangles for dollars and labeled circles for coins to draw these in your notes. She has $1, 1 quarter, and 1 dime. To find the total, we'll add their values, keeping dollars and cents separate. We only have $1. Easy. Now let's add the cents. The quarter has a value of 25. To add our dime, we can count up 10. We get 35. She has a total of 35 cents. If we put this together, Mia has $1 and 35 cents. But if you go to the store, you will see this written differently. Have you ever seen a price written like this? Here's a cool fact. The dot in prices is called a decimal point. It helps us show both dollars and cents in one number. The number before the dot, or decimal, is the dollar amount, and the number after is the cent amount. So our dollar and cent amounts come together to make $1.35. Think of that dot as the word and, separating the dollars and the cents. Do you notice something new? Using dollars comes with a new symbol, the dollar symbol. the dollar symbol is used a little differently than the cent symbol. Look closely at where the symbols are. When we write the cent symbol, we write it after the number, like it's written in 35 cents. But look, the dollar sign comes before the number. We use the cent symbol for amounts under $1, or 100 cents, and the dollar symbol for amounts over $1, or 100 cents. It's important to use the right symbols so people know exactly what kind of money we're talking about. After all, $100 is very different from 100 cents. Let's try another problem. Kayla has $2, 4 dimes, 2 nickels, and 3 pennies. How much money does she have altogether? We have $2. We can write that like this with our new symbol before the number. Now we'll add our coins, starting with the coin with the largest value, which is the dimes. Let's count up by tens to add these. 10, 20, 30, 40. Now, what do we count our nickels by? Right, by fives. Let's start at 40 and count up. 45, 50. And finally, our pennies, counting by ones. 51, 52, 53. She has 53 cents total. But what if we add our dollars? Right, $2.53, which we can write like this. Awesome job combining dollars and cents. It's time to put our practice to the test. Let's go back to our quest and see if we have enough money to play race car rally. This time we have $2, 3 quarters, 2 dimes, and 3 nickels. How many dollars do we have? Yes, 2. Pause the video and count, beginning with the coin with the greatest value, quarters. Our 3 quarters gives us 75 cents. Then we add our dimes, 85, 95, and finally our nickels, 100, 105, 110 cents. Wait a minute, we made it to 100 cents, which we know is equal to $1. That means we can exchange 100 cents for another dollar. Now we have $3. How many cents are left after our exchange? 10 cents. So our total is $3.10. Now, let's compare this amount to the price of the race car rally game, which costs 275 cents? This number is only in cents. What can we do to solve? You got it. We need to figure out what that means in dollars and cents. How many hundreds are in this number? 200. If each dollar is worth 100 cents, how many dollars do we have? 2. Then we have 75 cents left over. $2.75. Do we have enough money? Yes! We have more than $2.75. We can play race car rally. Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. Great work! We learned the value of a dollar, how to combine dollars with cents, and even how to exchange between cents and dollars. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time! Hey.